Hi friends, in this video we are going to see about breaking points in LoadRunner. In my last video, I have explained about debugging techniques and also we have seen about run step by step. So in this video, we're going to see how to make use of breaking points and how it can be useful if you're running with multiple iterations. So breaking point is a utility in Vuegen, which will help you to debug your script so that you can find the errors ahead of your actual load test. So breaking points, what it will do is it will pause your script at the middle of the execution so that you can carefully go to the next step, or you can carefully execute the step at which where you have inserted the breaking point. And also you can analyze the response headers, request headers, and other data. So this will help you make sure your script is fine, robust and reliable, so that you can go ahead with the actual execution without any issues. So to insert a breaking point, there are multiple ways in Vuegen. So one simple way is to by clicking on the line number. So assume that I want to insert a breaking point in the line number, 22 here. So what I can do is I can click on the just before 22, there is one column here. So just click on the line. So once you click on it, you can see there is a reddish circle has been inserted and it will highlight the whole line. So which means at this point during the execution, my script will pause and then it will wait for my input so that I can proceed with the next step, or I can continue my execution, or I can stop the execution. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on run button here. So once I click on run, what will happen? It will compile the script and then it will execute init action, and then it will execute two of my requests in the action. Then it will come to a pause in the line number 22, as you see in the video. So once it is in the line number 22, what will happen is it will display in the yellow background highlighted colors, which means it is waiting for the my inputs. So I have three options. As I said, I can go step by step, or I can run my script to continue the whole execution, or I can stop my script. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on step by step. So if I click on step by step, what will happen is it will go to the next request. So it will execute this particular request where I have inserted the breaking point, and then it will go to my next request and then wait for my input. So here I'm going to continue with my execution, and once the execution is done, you can see the replay logs in the output pane. So to delete the breaking point, what you can do is you can just click on the circle again. So now the breaking point has been deleted from my script. So while clicking, it will enable. Again, clicking on the same debugging, it will disable, it will delete the breaking point. I can insert multiple breaking points anywhere in the script. See, now I have three breaking points. So which means in three times, my script will pause the execution. But I don't want to delete my breaking point. So instead of deleting, I can disable. So to disable, right click on the breaking point and go to disable breakpoint. So once you disable breakpoint, what will happen is it will invert the color. It will just display the circle in the maroon color. So inside you can see the gray color, and outside it will fill outside it will cover with the maroon color. So right now the debugging the breaking point in line number 22 has been disabled. So now I'm going to delete the other two and I'm going to run my script. So the scenario is I have disabled the breaking point, and if I click on run, what will happen? We are going to see. So when it runs, what will happen is it will not pause the your script. It will continue execution because we have disabled it. Okay, again to enable it, you have to click again so that it will enable it. To disable, right click, disable. Okay, now assume that in my runtime settings I have 10 iterations, okay, in the run logic. So I'm the number of iterations is 10. Suppose if your script is failing on the fifth iteration or fifth parameter data, so how do I go to the particular number of iteration during when using the breaking point? So this trick, my you might not be aware of it. So I'm going to tell you how to insert a breaking point, how to debug your script using multiple iterations. So if the eighth iteration is failing out of 10, so how to go to that particular number of iteration using the breaking point. So just select the line, so in wherever the line you want to insert the breaking point, and right click and click on edit condition. So these three for the breaking points. Okay, so just click on edit condition. So here I have to create a condition for my breakpoint. So when break, when the iteration number is equal to 5. So what will happen is when the iteration is 5, is equal to 5, then only it will break. Otherwise it will not pass your execution. So we are going to see it now. Just click on OK. And for the demonstration purpose, I'm going to delete the remaining request. We will have only the three requests in the script, and the iteration is total number of iterations is 10 in the runtime settings, and the breaking point condition is we are going to set iteration number is equal to 5. Click on OK. Now hit run and go to runtime data so that we can see the iteration count. Just click on runtime data in the pane. So you can see the iteration 1, 2, 3, 4 is being done. So when the iteration number is 5, it comes to a pause, the line number 22. So this is how it's done when you are trying to debug your script using multiple iterations. So no need to wait for all of your iterations done so that you can do your debugging process, or no need to pause again and again for each iteration, because it's a waste of your time and effort. So you can insert a breaking point condition so that you can go pinpoint the which iteration it is failing, which iteration needs your attention. So similarly, you can add the breaking point for the parameters also. So what you can do is you can just right click, edit condition. So whenever you have a parameter, parameterization done in your script, so you can break when parameter value is some data. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to parameterize this. So right click, replace with the parameter, create a new parameter, and p_url, and file type, parameter type is file, click on properties, create table, click on OK here, and edit with notepad. And here what I can do is I can add some websites, hit save and exit, go with my by name URL, close, OK, yes, and delete these values, these requests, and insert a breaking point here, right click, edit condition. So now I can select when the p_value is equal to http://blaze.demo.com, and the iteration count is we can restrict to 2. And so what will happen is, so in the URL, in the parameters, we have two values, example.com and blaze.demo.com. I want to break, I want to pass my script when the value is equal to blaze.demo.com. So whenever the blizzdemo.com is been going to execute, I'm going to pass my execution. So that's why I have created a condition. When parameter p underscore URL value is equal to blizzmeter.com. So just click on OK and just make sure there is no spaces, extra spaces, because it's case sensitive. Okay, all is good. Now click on close and execute and go to your runtime data. So our expectation, it should break when the value is http://blazedemo.com. So in the runtime data, when the value is equal to blazedemo.com, it should pass. So we'll go check the condition again. Value is blazedemo.com. Yes. Click on OK. Hit run. You will see in the runtime data, it's pretty quick. Probably I have to increase the number of iterations here. So we will increase the number of iterations to 10, and then we'll see whether it is breaking or not. So go to runtime data. And okay, yeah. So now you can see the it has been paused. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on run again. And now again, the iteration number 5 also, it has been it's been pausing. And 5th also, it is, see, it's blessed demo, it's pausing. So likewise, it will keep pausing when the value is equal to blazedemo.com. So this is how it's done. If you want to break your pause your script using the parameter value condition. Okay. So I hope this video is pretty useful. So what we have seen is inserting a breaking point, deleting the breaking point, disabling the breaking point, and inserting the breaking point based on the condition. So I hope this video is pretty useful to you guys. And if you have any questions, please put it in the comments. I'll be happy to answer. And if you have time, go to my next video. Otherwise, thanks for listening. Have a great day.